Hello to all the English literature lovers. Welcome to my video class. Today I am going to discuss Thorudath's poem, Lakshman. This poem is prescribed for 4th semester BA and BSc students of Tumkur University. Learning objectives of the class are, first we'll begin with introduction of the poem, then we'll go on with the life and works of Thorudath, then we'll continue with summary and analysis, and end the class with conclusion. Now before going into the analysis, let us watch a short video clip which will help you to understand the poem in a better way.
मुझे लगता है कि राम संकट में है। ऐसा लगता है कि वो मदद के लिए पुकार रहे हैं। जल्दी जाओ और उनकी मदद करो।
आप चिंता मत कीजिए, ये राम की आवाज नहीं है।
लक्ष्मण, वहाँ तुम्हारा भाई संकट में है और तुम उनसे बहस कर रहे हो। जल्दी जाओ और उन्हें बचाओ। उनके बिना जीवन में सोच भी नहीं सकती। मैं स्वयं को समाप्त कर लूंगी।
ठीक है, जैसी आपकी आज्ञा। ध्यान रहे, किसी भी हालत में आप इस रेखा को पार न कीजिए। क्या आप इन घने जंगलों में अकेली रहती हैं? ये तो जंगली जानवर और राक्षसों से भरा हुआ है। मैं बहुत भूखा हूँ। क्या मुझे आप कुछ खाना दे सकती हैं?
जी, अभी लाती हूँ। आप जरा यहाँ रुकिए।
I hope you enjoyed the information video. Now the theme of the poem is taken from Ramayana, our Indian mythology. Mythology means Purana. The poem is a narrative ballad. As the word itself says, narrative means to tell. Tell a story. Whose story is told? Sita, Rama and Lakshmana's story is told. Here Thorudath uses dialogues between Sita and Lakshmana to tell the story. Now, as human beings, we are attracted towards stories. I still remember when I was in childhood, my Ajji used to tell a story. Ondu urittu, urali ganda henti idru. Once upon a time, there lived king and queen. Anta ee thara kategalanna kelkondu navu beltidivi. So, narrative ballad is a long poem which tells a story. So, here Thorudath is using very simple words to tell the story. A very simple diction is used. The poem begins suddenly. There is an abrupt beginning. And about this I am going to discuss when I am talking in summary. What she is trying to do is, she is trying to redefine the mythology. Now the video we saw there, it was quite simple. Lakshman tells to Sita that Rama is safe and he will not go. But Sita convinces him and he goes away. So much story we knew. But what here Thoru is trying to tell is, she is trying to redefine the character of Sita. We think that Sita is a woman who is having lot of patience. She is very docile. That impression we have. The impression is totally changed when we read the poem. So in that way we can analyze the poem from a feministic point of view. It is here Sita who controls the situation. She dominates the situation. It is Sita who decides what Lakshman will do. So that's why I've told you that she's redefining the Indian mythology. She's shown as a human being who can be angry. She's shown as the wife of Rama. More than a wife, she is a woman. She knows her rights. She knows to fight for her rights. Now, this poem and this kind of poem, as an Indian, Torudath is trying to answer to the Western world. Okay, this is our Indian mythology. And nobody can twist and interpret it as the colonialist writers did. Now, many clauses and phrases are used. Say, for example, swift in decision, prompt in deed. Swift in decision is quick in decision. There are many repetition of words. To stress the emotion in a ballad, the words are repeated. Now, say, for example, hark, Lakshman, hark. Hark means listen. Listen, Lakshman. So, the words are repeated. To stress the emotion, the words are repeated. That cry, that cry, that cry, that cry is repeated. Okay, I hope this is clear. In introduction, we saw that the subject matter is taken from Ramayana. Torudath is trying to redefine the character of Sita. The story is developed as a dialogue between Sita and Lakshman. So, there are many repetition of words and there are many clauses and phrases used in this. So, I was talking about feministic approach. About that, I am going to talk when I am talking about life and the works of Torudath. The poem is 176 lines. It's a quite long poem, but believe me, it's a beautiful poem. And the beauty of the poem lies in the dialogues. Very, very touchy dialogues. And we love the poem. Now, let us analyze Torudath's life. Torudath was born in 1856 and she died in 1877. She is the first Indian poetess to write both in French and English. Just imagine in 19th century, a woman writing in both languages, in French and English. So in that way, she is the first woman poetess to write in English. So she is a poet, a novelist, an essayist and a translator. Torudath, she died at the age of 21. In the age of 21, if she could have written such beautiful poetry, I don't know if she could have lived for another decade, she would have written more beautiful poetry. She is born in an aristocratic Bengali family. That's very important. Now, why this is important is, she comes from a Bengali family and the family is very broad-minded family. The family is well-read family. Her father himself is a minor poet. So, with that literary atmosphere, she is born. And there are no restrictions when she is born. The family gets converted into Christianity when she is just 6 years old. Then they go to settle in France. When they go in France, she is exposed to France culture. She learns French. She studies the literature. And she starts writing in French. She has written a novel in French. She has translated many poems from French to English. So, why this is very important is because of her upbringing, thanks to her upbringing, which has helped her to analyze the poem in a feministic point of view. Now, these are her important works, A Sheaf Gleaned in French Fields. These poems, they are a bunch of poems which is translated from French to English. Another important work is Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan. Lakshman is from this book. In this book, the subject matter of all of the poems are from Indian mythology. That's why I told you that she is trying to reinterpret Indian mythology and she is trying to tell the colonists, the Britishers, because we were a colony of Britishers, they twisted our interpretation. Tirchi Murchi avru namma mythology na heledru. As an Indian, she is answering to their questions. Okay, apart from those works, she has written Bineka or The Young Spanish Maiden. This is her only English novel, which was serialized in Bengali. Then this is a French novel, Lou Journal de Mademoiselle de Evers. So this is her French novel. Now before starting the analysis, now let us try to understand the character of Lakshman. Lakshman was a great character and he loved Rama more than his life itself. During Rama's exile, Lakshman decided to stay awake for 14 years. Just imagine, 14 years he tried to stay awake. He prayed for Nidra Devi that he should not sleep for 14 years, so that he can take care of Rama and Sita. And one more thing about Lakshman is, Lakshman is a true gentleman in the sense that he has never seen Sita's face. He could recognize only her toe. So this kind of a character is Lakshman. So keeping this in point of view, let us start the summary of the poem. Okay, now Ravana wants to kidnap Sita. So he's asked Maricha to disguise as a magical deer, which is yellow in color and it is having silver spots which are shining. So Maricha disguises as a deer and comes to the ashram of Sita. Sita sees the deer and she asks her husband Rama to go and hunt the deer. Rama, what he does, he asks Lakshmana to guard Sita and he goes to hunt the deer. When he's gone to hunt the deer, he kills the deer. Deer before dying, he is transformed into human being and he mimics the voice of Rama. He says, "Help Sita, help Lakshman." Sita asks Lakshman to help, but Lakshman stands and he won't help because he's very confident that nothing will happen to his brother. Brother who's a great warrior, a deer cannot kill him, and he knows that some enemies come and they're trying to dupe him by Rama's voice. But Sita is in no mood to listen. She starts arguing with Lakshman. Lakshman has no other go. He listens to her and he goes to hunt the, he goes to help his brother Rama. Summary tumba simple agide. Ravana Marichanage vesha mariskondo jinke veshadalli Sita nanna attract madu anta heltane. Aa jinke haladi bannadagirutte, alli silver chukkegalu irtave, aa silver chukkegalu minchta irtave. ಸೀತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಆಕರ್ಷಿತಳಾಗಿ ಅವಳು ಅವನ ಗಂಡನಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ, ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ಜಿಂಕೆಯನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ಬನ್ನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ರಾಮ ಹೋಗೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣನಿಗೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಅತ್ತಿಗೆ ಸೀತೆಯನ್ನು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೋ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಅವಳನ್ನು ಗಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡು, ಅವಳನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡು, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೀತಾ. ಹಾಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಈ ಜಿಂಕೆ ಸಾಯೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಅದೇನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ರೂಪವನ್ನು ಧರಿಸಿ ರಾಮನ ಥರ ಧ್ವನಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹಾಯಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಕಿರ್ಚುತ್ತೆ. ಸೀತೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾಳೆ, ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣನಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ರಾಮನಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಇವತ್ತು ಪಾಠದಲ್ಲಿ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್, ಸೀತಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣ್ ವಿತ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ. ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಶಿ ಡಸ್, now let us try to analyze the allegations of Sita. When she hears Rama shouting for help, she asks Lakshman, "Why standest thou as magic bound?" She asks him, "Why are you standing as if you're a stone, as if you're magic bound? What's wrong with you? Your brother is calling for help and you're just standing here. So if I were you, I would take my sword and bow and I would go and help my brother. But you are standing here, what's wrong with you?" Lakshman thinks that this is kind of a dupe, because he knows that his brother is a very big warrior. He has fought with many Rakshasas. He has fought with many big warriors. And Rama is born for a noble cause, and without doing that noble cause, he won't die. He's quite sure of that. But Sita is in no mood to listen. So she says, "Oh, I will run alone then. If you don't help me, then what I'm going to do? I'm having no other option. I'll go and help my husband. At least in the time of dying, we both can be together. Now come on, come with me, she says. But Lakshman is quite confident that nothing will happen to his brother. So he's just standing there. So she says, at least let us be together in death. If he's dying, okay, let me be with him. Let you be with him when he's dying. So she's trying to convince Lakshman. But Lakshman is in no way convinced by Sita's remarks. So he tries to calm her. He tells that, see, you have lost your reason. He says, oh, calm thyself, Vaidehin queen, he says. Calm thyself. You have some patience. Don't lose your patience, Vaidehin queen. Nothing will happen to our brother, Rama. You know that our brother is a very brave person, and who has killed so many animals. He has killed so many Rakshasas. So here he says, what being of dominion birth could ever brave his mighty arm? So no Rakshasa is made of that metal which can harm my brother. Nothing will happen to him. He is a big warrior. Now you see that on the screen you are seeing a bear is scared of Rama. Lions are scared of Rama. Rakshasas and Danavas have acknowledged that he is a great warrior. So he says, be thyself bold, great and wise. You are a very clever woman. You are a great woman. Because you being a princess, you came and you have started living with Rama for 14 long years in this forest. So you are a great woman. You are a very intelligent woman. So why are you panicking now? Nothing will happen. So she won't listen. Then he says, not of such metal he is made. He is not made of such metal. He is a very brave man. But she won't listen. Then what she does, she goes on insulting him. And let us see the insults what she makes. Now first she says, are you a coward? That question she asks. Are you a coward? I've seen you battling in the field. I've seen you like a warrior fighting in the field. I've seen you killing people. So, because of cowardice, you're not going? Then what is the reason? Then what is the motive? If you're not a coward, then what is the motive? What is the reason for not going? Then why are you here? Then there should be some reason. Okay, then I know. Then he's not moving. So she says, she makes a very, very bad allegation against Lakshman. Here, we sympathize with Lakshman. She says, I know what is your motive. You secretly love me and you want my husband to die. And if he dies, you can marry me. So you're loving me, she says. Let me quote. He perishes. Well, let him die. His wife shall be mine. That is what your intention is. You want to make me as your wife. Sita. Well, and see. One brother takes kingdom. But still Lakshman is not moving. So what she says? One brother has taken the kingdom. Bharata. One brother wants to marry his wife. Is this the reason? That's why you're not going? You're not a coward, I know. Okay. You have a motive of marrying me. So she makes on going allegations. She says, are you a spy? Are you a spy? Have you come to spy on us? Track him in his banishment. Banishment is exile. Track him is to give information to Bharata. Have you come here to give information? Then what is the reason? So now I came to know that you are not an open enemy. Neenu obba naya vanchaka. Nagta nagta manasalli yenella shatruthvavanna ittukondidya neenu. But just bear it in mind. If Rama dies, I too will die with him. I'm not going to survive my love, she says. I'm not going to survive my love. If Rama dies, at that moment, I'm going to kill myself. So she's telling him, stop pretending. In natane madod bitpidu neenu. In natane jasi dina nadiyala. Go and die in his defense. I'll remember you as my brother throughout my life. I'll be indebted to you. But don't pretend. Lakshmana thinks, no more a gentle Sita. angry and determined. She's not a gentle Sita. The Sita he knew for so long, she's not that Sita. Then Lakshman has no other go. He decides to go. Before going, he says, "If you have killed me with a dagger, I would have been more happy. But your words tortures me like a poisoned swords," he says. See how beautiful he is telling. "They tortured me like a poisoned swords. If you would have killed me there and then, I would have died. But these words will remain with me through my life," he says. Then he asks her a question. "Have I deserved that at thine hands of lifelong loyalty and truth?" As I've seen when we were analyzing the character of Lakshman, that Lakshman did not sleep for 14 long years so that he can take care of Rama and Sita. So he's asking a question. Do I deserve all this? I've been so loyal to you people. "Okay, but still no problem. I'm going to forgive you, Sita," he says. "I know that you are not the Sita which I have seen. You are very sad now, and your sadness and your insecurity is making you talk all this. But Sita, I am worried about one thing. I have promised my brother Rama that I am not going to leave you alone. So what to do? Idu nan varle dharma sankta agoitu. Hogde idre neevu nan mele apadane martira, aa apadaneyanna nan tadkolla shakti nanallilla. Hogibitre nan anna nan mele bejar maadkoltane. I don't know what to do." And language wild and wrong, he says. Wild and wrong. Wrong language you are using. Wild is you are just talking whatever comes to your mouth. There is no filter. "Allav, no other course," he says. I am left with no other option. I have to go. "Okay. Adre kettadadre nange agli. Mine be the crime. Nee vallevar agiri. Nan kettavan agiri." So he requests, "I'm going to draw a magic circle, Lakshman Rekha. And please, for heaven's sake, don't step out of the circle." He requests her. He lives with such a heavy heart, he requests the nature. He says, "Ace, sylvan gods that dwell among this dim, somber shades, cascades." He's requesting the forest god. Who's living in the forest? He's requesting the tree, the shadow, the waterfall to take care of Sita. Till when? Till he will return with his brother. Further, he says, "Till we return onto our own, I and brother, arm in arm," he says. I'm quite sure. Nanage khanditavaga gottide. Nan annanage eno agiralla. Nan kai kai hidkondu barovarguno nanna ಸೀತಾನ ನನ್ನ ಅತ್ತಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ನೀನು ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡು ಅಂತ ಅವನು ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಹೀ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಇಲ್ ಓಮನ್, ಅ ವಲ್ಚರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ಹೀ ಗೋಸ್. ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣ್ ಲಿವ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಹೆವಿ ಹಾರ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಸ್ ಐವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ರೀಡಿಫೈನ್ ದ ಮೈಥಾಲಜಿ. Okay, and one beautiful part of the poem is it can be read and enjoyed by young and old of all generations. Why? Because as Indians, we know the story of Sita, Prahlada, Dhruva and things. We know the story. And as this diction is very simple, it can be enjoyed by anyone. And what she has done is, she is not presenting the story as it is, but she is giving human qualities to the characters. Let there be Savitri, let it be Sita, or let it be Lakshman. Now her Western upbringing is surfaced in the poem. That's what I told you. She had a first-hand experience of reading French. She read that literature. And in her house there were no hinges. Her father and mother were open-minded. And because of that upbringing, she knew as a woman her rights. And she wants other women's also in the same way. So here we see that in the poem, Lakshman symbolizes loyalty, lifelong loyalty. Sita is shown as a human being and a strong character. and the story is developed through dramatic dialogues. Now, what is a striking feature of this poem is, the beauty of the poem is, I just was telling, like, it was the heart of the poem, it's the soul of the poem are the dialogues. The dialogues are very, very heart-touching. Sita is accusing and Lakshmana's heart-rendering response. We feel very bad as readers and we sympathize with Lakshman. But yes, we know that Sita is fighting for her rights. In that way, this is a feministic poem. Now, thank you for joining me. I hope the class was informative. If you have any doubts, you please leave in the comment box. Thank you very much.